I gotta ask you this. Toughest, I might tell, toughest accent for me to understand from your part of the world?
Scotland.
Scotland, Liverpool.
Greg McEwing, I cannot understand
him. Yeah. Hold on, he was up from Scotland, who else?
Liverpool.
Mm-hmm.
Where else?
How about Bolton?
Oh, like Newcastle, those areas. Bolton's not bad. Come on, you understand me.
No, I told you, your accent is easier to understand.
Here. Mine's, yeah.
And I told you why.
Yeah, why?
If not, then Ireland, some parts.
Oh, Ireland, yeah.
They
Ireland
talk fast.
Hard as well, to understand. It just depends which part. I mean, London is the easiest.
Yes.
Manchester's not too bad. Birmingham, okay. But when you go into like northeast of England, like Newcastle and those areas and Liverpool, and you know, it gets quite hard.
And it changes from kind of district to district, doesn't it?
Yeah, we live like only like an hour away. Yeah. Like Liverpool's 20 minutes away and the accent's totally different.
Where's Kell Brook from?
Sheffield.
Okay, his fight just got cancelled. You heard about that?
Yeah.
Why? Do you know?
Pray can't make weight. 154.
How is he gonna fight you at 47?
Who is Kell Brook gonna fight?
I'm not sure he's gonna fight, but I just saw a big story.
Who was he supposed to fight?
Brook or something?
Yeah. Nothing, I don't know. But if he can't make 54, he's in trouble.
Yeah. I mean, some big names at 154.
You know? Charlo beats him crazy.
Charlo, I mean, there's some big hitters. Lara. I mean, there's some big hitters.
Lara beats him. Jaime Munguia would beat him.
He's a beast as well.
Who?
Munguia, the new kid from TJ, 21-year-old.
How many fights does he have?
Maybe 26, 27?
Against Liam Smith.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I know you're not right.
Maybe 27 fights with like 22 knockouts, 23 knockouts, Joe.
Mm-hmm.
He's an exciting fighter.
Now, where did he do most of his fighting?
Tijuana. Okay. I would say the last one he fought Saddam Ali and he fought Liam Smith, all of everything else. TJ.
See, I never used to wear a head guard like this before. Yeah. So Joe's, instead of me wearing a ball, I used to always wear a ball. He's like, what? I'm telling him about the story about the head guard. So he had me, said, look, I'm not going to let you wear the ball. I'm not so, Joe, I'm so used to wearing the ball, headbutts come in, you blow. It's not. So he had me, for the last 5 weeks of the training, wearing this and making me spar like 12 rounds after 12 rounds. And I got so used to seeing shots so clearly. Like my accuracy.
It's hard to see with the bar?
Yeah, it is a little bit, but your accuracy, because you rely on the bar. You know when you hit, get hit, you rely on getting hit on the bar.
True.
You're like, oh, okay. But if you get hit here, you get hit right on the nose. So
it's not fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think it's a good move we made there, Joe.
Yeah, and plus, Joe told me once, if I'm not mistaken, that if fighters get hit, the leather, the skin gets used to it. You get used to it. Versus if you never get hit in camp.
Yeah, true. That's why sometimes good to spar with no head guards on.
Yeah.
Well.
No head guards on and small gloves, like the MMA gloves. They'll get your skin tight.
Well, I'm not going to get that.